The recruiting tour here at Georgia Public Broadcasting continues around the state. Next stop, Hinesville and Bradwell Institute, where we catch up with top 40, according to 24/7 Sports, on the highest undeclared talent in the state, Elyjah Thurmon, all 6'5", 278 pounds of offensive tackle. Elyjah, thanks for hanging out with us.
Thank you for having me.
All right, so when you look back at this season, how do you think you grew as a senior? What did you need to work on, and how do you think you grew on the field?
I think it's mostly I had to learn how to switch positions. So last year, my junior, I played tackle. So now I went into playing center this year and playing more of an interior role. So I had to learn to be the main guy, the head honcho of the offensive line, as also being one of the main leaders of the offense. So that means calling plays, rotations, reading blitzes, anything that just that would just help us lead our offense.
How much of a challenge was that for you, getting all of this responsibility put on you by Coach Brock and everybody down there at Bradwell?
It was a lot to take in at first, but once I got the hang of it during the summer, it kind of just was second nature for me. It was easy to pick up on.
All right, so let's walk through a play here real quick. All right, so play's been called in the huddle. We go up to the line of scrimmage. You're over the ball, and you're starting to look at the defense that's in front of you. Give me all of your cadences here before the ball is snapped. So quarterback's behind you. You're over the ball. Run me through a play and what you're going through right there as center.
So if we run, I'll say our zone left play, we're going to be reading between our guards. It'll be between their three technique and their one technique where it is. So we'll call a double team for either this side or to the opposite side. And then if it is a double team, which one of us will peel off to the linebacker that's going to flow over towards once the play starts. And then everything else is mostly backside tackle. Is either going to hold off the DN or he's going to climb up for himself. And our other tackle, depending on if that end slants in, he'll probably just watch him down or he'll just go outside. So mostly it's just everything starts with our interior three. So our two guards and me is where everything really needs to be called for. It. So it's either a double team where everybody has a solo and going up to the back.
How long did it take you to become that comfortable doing that?
I'll have to say once we got through the spring, I got to do everything for that entire week or two, getting ready for our spring game. Then summer came, we got going to camps and everything. That's when everything started to pick up for me, and I got comfortable doing it.
Elyjah Thurmon, interior lineman for Bradwell Institute, hanging out with us here as we look through recruiting here in the state of Georgia on Football Fridays. 22 offers on the table. What are you looking for when it comes to playing at the next level?
Looking for a place that I can call home, somewhere that treats me like family, but also is going to mold and groom me to be able to be one of those great guys in college, and also be a guy to make it to the NFL.
So what do you think you still need to work on as you get ready to go to the next level? Because I'm looking at the list, and it's alphabetical. You're Alabama State, App State, Chattanooga, Clemson, Coastal, and the complete team list as I sit here and click on a button. Coastal, Duke, Florida, FAU, Fort Valley, Georgia Southern. So, I mean, you're looking at D1, you're looking at FCS, D2 is also interested. When it comes to making it feel like home, does it matter if it's a large school or if it's a small school? What environment are you most comfortable in?
I'll say probably have to be like D1. So it'll be at those higher tier schools. So those SEC schools and those ACC schools, because those programs mostly produce the most amount of guys, and especially because it's the highest level of football that I want to be able to be a part of and play in.
So when it comes to chasing after a degree and being a student athlete, and obviously you want to go up two levels from high school, what do you want to be when you grow older, not necessarily grow up? In addition to doing football, what do you want to do when you grow older?
It'll either be an x-ray technician or a physical therapist. But if that doesn't work, if I don't do that, then I'll become an engineer, and possibly I can do the underwater welding, maybe. If not, probably do a little construction or something like that.
How did you come across those? Because that's a varied batch of interest there. How did you come across those three?
I got interested in engineering and welding and things like that. My sophomore year, I had a welding class, and then I did that for half a semester, I believe. It was real nice. I did really good in that. Then the physical therapist and healthcare part was, my mom has a degree in sports medicine herself. So I kind of grew up around that.
No doubt about it. Elyjah Thurmon hanging out with us for another couple of minutes here as we tour the state when it comes to recruiting. For someone who's never been to Bradwell, never been to that part of the state, never been to the coast, never seen football, you know, I know that, you know, it means a lot down there. For someone who's never been to your part of the state to see what it means to Bradwell and to Hinesville and that part of the state, how would you break down what football and sports in general mean to the experience down there at Bradwell Institute?
Sports is really serious when it comes down here, especially us being in the South Georgia region. Everything is more physical, it's more passionate down here than it is in our northern and western part of Georgia, in the Atlanta area and whatnot. It's not much as flashy and glorified, but it's more physical, it's more fast paced and everything like that. So it's like the community, everybody just comes together and is really serious about it since it's so much tradition around here.
They say, you know, 6'5", 278, it depends on, you know, who's looking at you and what you're weighing on any given day. Have any of these coaches that have come by, knocked on your door saying, you know, we need you to be up closer to 300? What are they telling you about your physicality and your skill set?
They said my physicality is good. My skill set is good. I got great feet for my size. I can move in space for someone my size. And it all just really depends on, well, during the summer, I was trying to pick up weight because I was a little bit lower than most interior guys. But they're saying that I can move around at the weight I am now, but also just wanting to slim down and then put on some more muscle mass.
Well, we're looking forward to seeing you take those next steps and looking forward to seeing you next year when it comes to college football. Elyjah Thurmon, Bradwell Institute, 6'5", 278, top 40 here in the state of Georgia, top undeclared talent in the state. Find Elyjah Thurmon, track him down, and have him be a part of what's going on next season there at your particular favorite college university. Elyjah, thanks for hanging out with us here at GPB.
Yes, sir. Thank you for having me.